हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट वुमेन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। दिस इज लेक्चर 5 ऑफ एंटीनास फॉर मोबाइल कम्युनिकेशन सीरीज एंड इन दिस लेक्चर 5 वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इन्वर्टेड एफ एंटीना। द फॉलोइंग कंटेंट्स विल बी एड्रेस्ड ड्यूरिंग दिस लेक्चर 5। इनिशियली द ज्योमेट्री एंड of inverted F antenna will be discussed, then the design equation and so one problem based on the inverted F antenna design is investigated. The following reference book is considered to prepare the contents of this lecture. As we have discussed in previous lectures about planar inverted F antenna and slot antenna, then we get some outcomes from this study, and in this lecture 5 we are going to discuss about inverted F antenna, and it is also a similar kind of antenna but having some basic difference, and we can compare this inverted F antenna to the slot antenna as we have discussed in previous lecture, I mean lecture 4 of this series. So we can say that a inverted F antenna consists of a thin arm of wire shorted at one of the ends to the ground plane, as you can see here. This is the figure of inverted F antenna, and in this figure you can see if we are considering the full size of ground plane and we are providing the feed at the center, then in that case we are saying it is just slot antenna, planar slot antenna. If we have cut some part of this slot antenna and we are taking the length L equal to lambda by 4 and we are providing the sorting pin, as you can see this is sorting pin and having the width of W and the length of radiating element L is equal to lambda by 4, and when we are looking this from the top view, in that case you can see the inverted F antenna designs. So here you can see in a slot antenna it is completely connected with the ground plane with a sorting pin, and when we have eased this part of conducting surface, then we are providing the feed V, and this is sorting pin and this is the length L. If we can see from the side view, then we are not considering the ground plane below the substrate, but here we are considering the ground plane as well as radiating plane in the same plane, so we are calling it is a coplanar antenna. And because the shape of this structure looks like the F, then we are saying it's a inverted F. You can see here we are providing the feed and this is the one arm, it is called as the sorting pin, and this, so this is the inverted F shape of an antenna. The length of the arm should be nearly equal to lambda by 4, so the position of the feed with respect to sorting pin controls the input impedance. So here you can see the one important discussion is that the position of the feed. Here you can see this is the sorting pin and this is the position of feed. So input impedance matching can be obtained by properly choosing the gap between the sorting pin and the feed element. As the feed becomes closer to the sorting pin, the input impedance is reduced. Thus, to obtain a 50 ohm impedance used in most practical designs, the feed should be closer to the sorting pin than to the open end. So we can say for proper impedance matching, the gap between the sorting pin and the feed is very small. In that case, we can create the inductive as well as the capacitive coupling between the elements. In that case, we can get the input, perfect input impedance matching when the feed element is close to the sorting pin. So this is the important Although the IFA looks like the PIFA, as we have discussed, with a wire or thin arm instead of planar patch, its performance is slightly different from the PIFA antenna, and that we will discuss in the subsequent slides of this lecture. And the performance of inverted F antenna is similar to that of the slot antenna, as we have discussed. The length of the IFA should be half of the slot antenna. So we can say in a slot antenna this length is equal to lambda by 2, but in the case of inverted F antenna this length is equal to L equal to lambda by 4. So this is the important design parameter through which we can calculate the length of the inverted F antenna design when the frequency of operation and substrate properties are given. If the slot antenna is halved, then the physically create an open circuit, it reduced to an IFA where performance is ideally similar to that of the original slot antenna. So here you can see again, as we have discussed in the slot antenna, this will create a open circuit. As we have discussed the voltage and current distribution during the analysis of the slot antenna, so the performance of inverted F antenna is looks or is like similar performance as we have discussed in the slot antenna. The sorting pin, as we have discussed, introduced the input impedance, and sorting pin introduced to the input impedance and inductance LS, while the open ends introduce the capacitance CS. So we can say this sorting pin create the LS, and the gap between feed element and the sorting pin create the capacitance through which we can get the input impedance. So to obtain the impedance at a resonance, the two reactive components should be cancelled out, leaving only the radiation resistance. The width W of sorting pin very small compared to wavelength W. So we can say the width W is very very small as compared to wavelength that we have considered. In that case, the W again, the width of the sorting pin is similar to the slot antenna as we have discussed. And this value we are considering for the practical application is less than or equal to this range, but generally we are considering it 0.06, 0.07 in terms of lambda. So we can say in comparison of the slot antenna and inverted F antenna, it is find out that the slot antenna having the length L equal to lambda by 4 and other correct width is same as we have discussed in inverted F antenna. So we can say the slot and inverted F antenna are similar except the length of the radiating element. In the inverted F antenna, the length of the radiating element is lambda by 4, but in the case of slot antenna, it is lambda by 2. There are various configuration that is being used in mobile devices, and some other kind of wire antenna and non-planar antenna, as you can see. So these are some other kind of wire type inverted F antennas, and here you can see we are taking one inverted F antenna, and this is some kind of wire antenna. So this is a arm having the length L, and this is the feed we are providing. So here we are providing the coaxial feed from here, you can see, and this is the ground plane, and this is the height H1 of the surface of the substrate, and this is the edge, that is, this is the sorting pin that is being used in a wire type inverted F antenna, and this is the length T, and this is the overall length L, and having the width of this element is W. In that case, the length of L plus H1 is normally equal to the half quarter wavelength, which is equal to lambda by 4, and the T is less than lambda. So this is the analysis that we have considered. In that case, we can easily match the input impedance by creating the inductive tuning from this element and the capacitive between two elements. So we can easily get the resonance of this wire type of inverted F antenna. So this is another important configuration that is being used, and this type of structure is called as a non-planar structure, or we are considering it's a wire type inverted F antenna. And the physical significance and radiation mechanism is same as we have discussed during the analysis of slot antenna about the voltage distribution as well as the current distribution. So similar principle that we can get or we can implement on this type of structure also. We are taking one problem to understand the inverted F antenna, and it is designed on Rogers RT-Duroid 5870 substrate having dielectric constant 2.33 and thickness is given 0.1524 centimeter and resonating at 1.8 gigahertz. It is a cellular communication band, and we need to determine the length L, and we have also simulate the design and to analyze the reflection coefficient S11, 3D and 2D patterns. So this problem is analyzed in this book by this professor Balanij, and we are first calculate the length L by using L equal to lambda G by 4, and here we are putting some expression values, I mean parameter values. In this case we are getting the length L equal to 2.73, and similarly as we have discussed that the width W which lies in the range of point less than or equal to 0.05 lambda. So in that case we are considering W equal to 0.06 lambda. In that case we are getting length and width. Then further we can design the inverted F antenna by using these length and width of the IFA antenna in any computational electromagnetic software. It may be the HFSS software, it may be the CST software, or it may be the other kind of CM software. In that case, when we are considering this design parameter for IFA, in that case we are getting the reflection coefficient magnitude, and here you can see this is the reflection coefficient, and we have discussed that F is equal to 1.8 GHz. So here you are getting the resonance frequency after CM analysis, computational electromagnetic software analysis. We are getting similar response as the frequency of operation, but it is slightly having the variation. It may be due to the inductive or maybe the capacitive coupling that is created within the IFA design. Further, we have to analyze the normalized 3D and 2D radiation pattern, and this here you can see the radiation pattern is looks like the dipole like radiation pattern, I means in a H plane that we have discussed in the XZ plane, and it is having the omnidirectional plane, omnidirectional radiation pattern. But in the case of YZ plane, and in that case we are getting the some kind of bidirectional radiation pattern. So we can say in comparison of the slot antenna, and in comparison of PFA antenna, and in comparison of microstrip antenna, we can say that this kind of inverted F antennas having some better radiation characteristic irrespective of the PFA antenna, because in a PFA antenna you have discussed about the hybrid type of radiation characteristics, and in the microstrip antenna we have discussed about the unidirectional radiation characteristics, but in the case of IFA we are getting some bidirectional in the E plane and omnidirectional in the H plane. So we can say that the IFA antenna design is very popular in the case of mobile communication, because we are getting some kind of dipole like radiation pattern characteristics in a IFA design, inverted F antenna design. So we have discussed in this lecture about the design configuration of inverted F antenna, then how we can design the inverted F antenna, and we are taking the length L equal to quarter wavelength, which is equal to lambda by 4, and W we are getting less than or equal to 0.05 minus 0.1 lambda. So we are getting generally 0.06 lambda, and this structure we can simulate it on a various type of CEM software, and then after we can analyze here a reflection coefficient magnitude as well as radiation pattern in 2D and 3 dimensional, and that we have discussed in this lecture 5 of this series. Thank you everyone for watching this lecture. I hope this lecture is beneficial for you.